Hi, in this video we're going to look into how we can make railway tracks with Splines 2.0 in Unity. Let's get started. Unfortunately, extruding custom meshes along a spline is still not supported with Splines 2.6, which means we have to rely on custom scripts. In the GitHub link in the description below, you'll find the link to a package. Go ahead and download the zip folder for this, open it up, and then double click on the spline mesh version 1. You generally do not need to import the examples. This just contains a bunch of blend files and Fbx files. I'm just going to leave this checked and hit import. But you don't necessarily need to import the examples. Okay, so this imports a folder called spline tools. Just open it up, and there are two important scripts here. We have spline mesh and spline mesh resolution. Spline mesh is used for making things like roads, and spline mesh resolution is best for making railway tracks. You can use spline mesh for railway tracks as well, but I think it's generally more work. So let's get started. So there are some prerequisites that you need to worry about when you're modeling the mesh. So the first thing is that the origin point should be at the center at 0, 0, 0, like this. And the mesh should go outwards along the positive x-axis or the positive y-axis. In this case, we are going through the positive y-axis. Also, if I press tab, you can see that the mesh is subdivided along this y-axis as well. Because I'm in Blender, I'm also using the array modifier. You can also work with a single track and then it would still work. But it would not work well with the spline mesh script, which I will also show you in this video. So just three prerequisites. The origin point should be at the center. The mesh should go along the positive x-axis or the positive y-axis. And the mesh should be subdivided. Those are the three conditions. And this works with blend files, FBX files, and OBJ files. So first up, let me create a spline. Something like this should work. If you need to smooth a knot, you can click on it and press auto. And then we simply add spline mesh resolution. I will move this up so that you can see it better. Okay, the first thing that we need is a material. And this mesh contains two submeshes. One goes horizontally and one goes vertically. This means you have multiple materials. So I need to add two materials in this case. I'm going to drag the white and then I'm going to drag the brown. I should have named it pink or something. And we're done with the things at the bottom. Now let's focus on the spline mesh resolution script. First, we need a spline container, which is the spline container here. We can just drag and drop this here. It would work. But there is a handy button called self. We can just click that and it will automatically assign references. And over on the segment mesh, this is where we need to specify the mesh we want to duplicate or extrude. So we're going to open up the blend file, drag and drop this track. We can give it a name. Let's just call this track spline. And the forward axis is the axis that it repeats. So this is going to be y-axis in this case. And then we have an array called resolution. And let's just leave it at 10 and hit generate. And you can see that the mesh gets generated and it's awesome. We can go to this resolution. This is an integer. If I tone it down to, let's say, 4 and hit generate again, you can see that the resolution of the mesh decreases, but the mesh still goes along the spline. We can leave it to 1 and you can see how the algorithm works. This just divides the mesh into how much resolution that we want, and this just stretches the mesh. I'm going to leave it at 6 because, yeah, I think that works best. And that's it. If you want to close this loop, you can go ahead on the spline 0 and then hit closed. And this automatically generates it, okay? And you can see that there is a weird shape here. We can go to the spline editor, click on this. This is set to auto. This is also set to auto. Now, which means we just need to just move it around to just make it more rounded. Cool, that's it. And that's all we need to do to make railway tracks work in Splines 2.0. Isn't it really cool? There are options to increase the UV resolution and stuff like that. If you are working with realistic textures, you can check out my spline roads video to learn how that works. You can see that the mesh also regenerates as we move the spline. If you want to turn that feature off to save performance while you're in the editor, you can just go to this and then click on auto generate mesh on spline modified. And this will toggle it off. And now we can just simply move the spline without regenerating the mesh, and you can manually hit generate. And that will generate the mesh. If your mesh gets big, this could cause some lag. Also, if your mesh sinks in below the ground plane, you can click on the mesh and then change the Y offset to something like 0.2 and hit generate again. And you can see the mesh goes up. okay, this is how you change the offset. And then if you want to increase the scale, we can play around with it. You can set it to 1.5 and hit generate again. And you can see the mesh just scales up. Cool. This also works if you have a separate spline in the same spline container. If you hit generate, you can see that it works. But you can see the weird issue here. This is because we have an array and that updates itself based on the number of splines you have in this container. So on element 1, which is this new spline here, we can reduce the resolution to something like 2. Hit generate. You can see how you could get a similar result. And now it looks equal. So you can manually set the resolution to an integer of your choice. If you were to use the spline mesh script instead, it doesn't have a resolution feature. So if I hit generate, you can see how weird it looks with the spline mesh script. You can see how the mesh would get stretched based on the distance between the splines. You could make it work. This is much better used for things like roads, but you can make this work by just playing around and then adding points necessary to make things look even. Okay, but this is just a quick and easy alternative. Just a quick note, if you were to use the FBX files and hit generate, it doesn't work. We just need to offset the scale by 100. So 1.5 becomes 150, 1 becomes 100, the set becomes 100, and hit generate again. And you can see this works. And this means we have to change the resolution to something higher so that this gets updated. If you were to use the OBJ files, the mesh would look very weird like this. In that case, we just need to offset the rotation X by 90 and hit generate again. And then it would work properly as expected. Yeah, that's it. That's everything you need to know about setting up railway tracks inside Splines 2.6. Let me know what you think of the package. In the next video, we're going to be looking at how we can set up conveyor belts along splines with custom legs. So it's going to be awesome. So I'll see you then.